Today I'm going to talk about the optical end stop for the Smart RAMPS board. So let me point out the pins. We have our voltage pin right here that I've marked with red, and there's the pin. Then we have our signal pin, which is in the center. And then we have our ground, which I've marked with black, and there's the pin. In a moment, I'll talk about the front side of the optical end stop and how to set it up. Here's the front side of the optical end stop. Now, what happens is a beam is usually broken by a solid object, such as this dental pick, and that causes this to think that a circuit has been formed. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect the cable and then connect it to the Smart RAMPS board. Okay, to connect the cable, what I've done is there's notches on here that match up to the notches on the back side of the board over here. So all you have to do is insert, and there you go. Now on the other end, I traced out what the colors are. So we have red for this lead, black for ground, and then the blank one is signal. So in a second, I'll show you how to connect it to the Smart RAMPS board. Okay, before we can connect the end stop sensor for the optical end stop, we need to know our pins. So we have Xmin, we have Xmax, we have Ymin, we have Ymax, we have Zmin, and then we have Zmax. Now the pins across the top are signal, the pins in the center are ground, and the pins at the bottom are voltage. So we're going to use Xmax, which is right here. So first we're going to connect the voltage pin, then we're going to connect the ground pin, and then we're going to connect the signal pin. In a moment, I'll show you how to connect the USB and load the Marlin firmware. Okay, in order to connect the serial USB, we have to connect the port at the very bottom closest to the power supply on the Arduino Due, and then we're going to connect the other end to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. Now keep in mind, once it's been energized, you don't want to touch this area. So in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay. We're going to open up the Marlin-Bugfix-2.0.x. This is an experimental firmware, so keep that in mind. We're going to open up Marlin's folder, then we're going to go to the source folder, then we're going to open up the core folder. Now there is a file called boards.h, which has a definition of all boards in it, so we're going to open that up. And as you can see, I have selected in here board_ramps_smart_EFB. We're going to copy that. We're going to close out of this file. And then we're going to go back a directory, then another directory, and we're going to open up marlin.ino. Now we have three tabs in the Marlin.ino. We have our Marlin tab, we have our configuration.h tab, and then we have what's known as our configuration advanced.h tab. So we're going to go to configuration.h. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And then we're going to replace motherboard being board_ramps_14_EFB. With what we copied from boards.h. Next, we're going to search on end stops. And because we're connected to Xmax, we're going to uncomment use_Xmax_plug. Next, we're going to check to make sure that we have the right board selected, which we do. It's the Arduino Due programming port. And then we're going to check to make sure that we have the right COM port selected, which we do. So next what we're going to do is compile and upload with the upload button. And then I'll show you how to test it in Pronterface. Okay, we're going to open up Pronterface. We're going to connect to the printer. Now we're going to check to see what the status of the end stops is by typing M119 and pressing enter. And right now it says that XMAX is open. So I'm going to place a piece of paper inside the optical end stop to trigger it. And now I'm going to type M119 again and press enter to see what the status is. And now it says triggered. Now I'm going to remove the piece of paper. And now I'm going to type M119 again and press enter. And now it says open. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.